Hi, Jason here from Electric Bike Technologies. This video is going to show you how to program the LCD for your e-bike kit. This is for the no-key model. This model was available with the e-bike kit, is available with the e-bike kit 2017 through 2020. Very important, you need to program this. We have a couple different options, motors and batteries, and it's important that you get this right so that your readouts are correct. Okay, we see a lot of people who don't program this out of the box, and then they call us with problems and we have to walk through programming, which is why we're making this video. So let's follow along. When you get a kit brand new, it's gonna say that right there. So program me, you must program this LCD before your first ride. It's easy stuff, see manual for setup instructions. This is the manual, I have a paper copy here. This manual is available at ebikekit.com. If you go down on the footer all the way at the bottom of the website, there's a link there. Click on that, you're gonna see two PDF versions of the manual. One of them is for the e-bike kit, and one of them is for the e-trike kit. If you have an e-trike kit, it is for an upright traditional trike only, and it's got some special features. So you pick the right manual, okay? Same LCD, same kind of setting. So, all right, let's go through them. So make sure you have power going to your battery. So you have your system set up, your key turned on, whatever battery you have plugged in. We're gonna pull off this protective covering, get into it. The push pad here has three different buttons on it. We have an up arrow, we have a down arrow, and then we have the M button, which ends up on the side or the bottom, depending where you put this on your bar. We're gonna quick press the M button to turn it on. And once it's on, to make things easier to read, we're gonna get the backlight going, and that's where you hold down the up arrow, and you see the backlight come on. Now you can see full battery, that's the indicator across the top. We've got the 0 miles per hour, zero power level, and then zeros across the ODO since it's brand new. So what we're gonna do is, we're gonna jump right into it, we're gonna look at the manual, we're gonna get into the settings. Now the way that you access the settings menu is you hold down both up and down arrows simultaneously for 2 seconds. So you press that in, and then you see that this comes up. Now, ST stands for setting one. Setting one has to do with miles or kilometers. We're in the US, so it's gonna be miles, and that's where it is by default. If you wanted to change that, you simply use the up and down arrow to switch between the options. And then when you have your option correct, you're gonna quick press the M button to move to the next setting. So we press that once, we get to ST2. Now ST2 is your top speed. This is where you would govern your top speed. If you wanted to do that, this is listed in kilometers and that doesn't change, okay? So you would have to do the conversion to miles per hour depending on where you want to go. But 50 is the top, and that's where most people leave it there usually. So we'll move on to ST3. One quick press of the M button, ST3. 26-inch wheel, that's where it is by default. You may have something else. You can cycle through and see what the appropriate wheel size is. Hopefully you ordered the right wheel size for your bike. Wheel size is found on the sidewall of your tire. That's the best way to know what kind of wheel size you have. So let's say it's 26 inches. We're gonna cycle through to ST4 now that we're cool with the 26-inch wheel size. We're gonna hit M one time, quick press. And over here, ST4 is gonna be your motor type. Now, this is what it looks like, it's DD5. DD5 stands for direct drive. This over here, if you back up for a second, take a look. This bigger size motor here, this is a direct drive. So if you have this motor, this is your setting, DD5. That stands for DD 500 watt, okay? Over here, we have a geared motor, and I'm gonna show you if you press the up and down arrow to change through the selection. So here you get GRD5. That's this motor, okay? Those are the two motors that we offer. We also offer a fat motor, which happens to be a geared 500, so it doesn't matter. Same setting, geared 5. There is another option here, which looks like BG5, kind of big. That is not for most people. This happens to be, we use the system on another tricycle, so 9.9 times out of 10, you're not wanting that. You're gonna want DD5 for direct drive, or you're gonna want geared 5 for the smaller diameter geared 500 watt motor, okay? It's very important that you get this motor selection right. So look at what you look at what we have here, know what you have there, and pick appropriately. Geared, GRD5, and direct drive, DD5, very important. All right, that's ST4. ST5 is gonna be the battery type, and we're gonna quick press again. We're gonna leave this on geared 5. We're gonna quick press again, M, to get to ST5 or setting 5. And here we go, it says 36 Li. That means 36 volt lithium. So if you have a 36 volt lithium battery from us, that's gonna be your choice. Nowadays, in 2020, we sell mainly 48 volt, although the system will work at 36, we're all 48 volt. So you get 48 Li. If you have any of our batteries that are 48, no matter the size, choose 48 Li. And then we have 36 SLA, which is real old school. Not many people use it anymore, 48 SLA. We left those options in there because it's been done, you know, many times over the years. The fifth option here for battery is DIY. When you get into DIY, if you do that, then it's up to you to do a volume curve. That's a little bit more complicated. If you were to choose that guy, then you would have to go in at the end here and set up the system for DIY. You would really need to know your discharge curve of your third-party battery. And that's what that's for. That's really unique to E-BikeKit, by the way. All right, so we're going to move by the battery, choose the right battery, and then get up to ST6, which is setting 6, and this is the assist level. We want to have all the defaults here. That's fine. We can get into more of the assist level at the end of this video. So ST6 is assist level. Default is 0 through 5. Okay, that's 0 through 5 power settings. Leave that there. We're going to click the M to get to ST7. ST7 is the current limit. The max limit for the E-BikeKit controller is 20 amps. Okay, so you can only turn that down if you want to reduce power, if you wanted to make the whole system weaker and limit the amount of current going through the controller, you could do that. 20 is tops. That's, you know, 9.9 out of 10 times you're going to leave it right there. So at 20. So we're going to move on to ST8 for the PAS settings. We're going to do that with, again, with a quick press of the M. ST8. P1-03. Now these are the pedal assist settings. P1-03. Now you can move this up or down. This is the startup. This is the number of magnets that must pass by the sensor before the PAS engages. Fine-tuning this setting can help control how soon the motor turns on when starting from a stoplight or when resuming pedaling after coasting, for instance. Okay, by default, we like to put this on 5, okay? If you wanted it to kick in earlier, you could lessen the number of magnets that have to pass. If you wanted more of a delay, you would increase that number to increase the delay. So we'll click M to move through the next, which is P2 inside of setting 8 for the pedal assist. This is the power ratio. We leave this guy at 5 by default. You can turn it, you can go anywhere between 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and that's going to transition the power level over. So this is the max. That's where it is by default. We hit M again, P3, but this is set at 25. Default should really be around 7. This one is PAS scaling, total number of magnets. So what this does, if you turn this down, if you turn this number down, it will increase the proportion of motor speed relative to pedaling speed. So if you want to go faster with less pedaling, turn this number down. If you find the motorcycles on and off while you're pedaling, turning this number down can help. So it can make it a little bit more responsive. So I'm going to take this down to default. I'm going to take this, you go one way or the other, and I think 50 is the top, and we'll get back to 7. And then we'll hit M to lock that in. We'll get to ST9 now. So setting 9, this one's pretty important. This is drive mode setting. By default, it's drive mode 1-3. 1-3 is the default, and that means that it's pedal assist, which is working off the cadence sensor included in the system. So it's pedal assist, meaning you're going to turn that crank, it's going to pick up your cadence, it's going to feel those, the sensor's going to get those magnets, it's going to actuate that throttle or that auto pedal assist function from pedaling, right, that we just went over in ST8. This drive mode is pedal assist with a throttle override. So you have pedal assist, but then anytime you grab that throttle on the handlebar, it's going to override the pedal assist and you can take off. Okay, that's the default. That's how most people want it. So that's 1-3 and that's the default. If you change this, we also have right there, we would have 1-1. 1-1, and this is in the manual, would be pedal assist only. Okay, and if you change it to 1-2, that would be throttle only, rendering the pedal assist unresponsive. You could also do this by physically removing one or the other. It wouldn't matter what drive mode you were in. If you remove the throttle and you only have pedal assist, the pedal assist will work, and vice versa. If you remove the pedal assist or don't hook it up and only use the throttle, drive mode setting doesn't matter. It's just going to pick up the one that is actually plugged in and connected. Okay, I hope that's clear. We're going to get to a final setting here. We go through ST9 and finally get to this, which is STA and 55-1. If you have a geared motor, this is actually not 55, it's SS, and it's speed sensor is what it stands for. So if you have a geared motor, it's important that this SS says 1. Okay, that's going to pick up your speed in a geared motor. If you have a direct drive, it really doesn't matter what setting it's on. It's going to work. So then we're going to press it one more time. At the end of all the settings here is where the DIY stuff comes in for a third-party battery. If you wanted to program this, it's basically five segments of 20% each for the indicator on the top of the LCD. And you can actually put in the voltage at each 20 increment going from right to left. Those five increments, you're going to go down and put those in. Now, you would really need to have some details on your third-party battery that you want to use with our kit, and you would really need that discharge curve along the way. This is real-world testing. Nobody does it. People hardly ever do this, but if you had a battery, if you're into it, if you know what I'm talking about when it comes to a discharge curve for the voltage, then you could certainly get in there and create your own indicator to work with your battery and do some fine tuning. Please don't ask us about that. If you choose any of the other options on the battery setting, where you choose your battery type, that's ST5 in that setting, you choose any of those other options like 36Li, 48Li, 36SLA, 48SLA, we've already done the work there. We've mapped it out. Those are going to be real close, and that indicator is going to be pretty accurate. So we've gone through all the settings. I click the M again, and we're back at the main screen. Now, anytime you do something in an LCD like this, you want to cycle on and off for these settings to take effect. Don't just go riding away and think everything's cool. So the way to do that is to turn off is to hold down the M button. So this is a long press, and the LCD will turn off. And then a quick press, it will come back on. Again, the up arrow for a couple seconds, and you'll get the backlight on. And that is how you program your LCD. This is very important. If you get the motor setting wrong, if you don't know which motor you have and you put into direct drive, but it's really a geared, the LCD knows that. The timing will be off. It will render some nonsense. It won't work. So it really matters which one. So if you have speed that's off, there's two things that can do it. Number one is you may have the wrong motor type programmed, or you have the wrong wheel size. So go back and check those. But now you can see, based on what you have, what you need to do. Okay, and hopefully that's all clear. But if you ever get anything on here that doesn't make sense, it's important that you should go into your LCD, go through each one of those settings as I've shown you, and just make sure that what you have matches the settings on the LCD.